I want to work with the best operators across the country, not just ones that are good at what they do, but the ones that are actually doing good as well, right? Like the last deal we nice. Bought was 300 units in Winston-Salem. We partnered up with the DeRosa Group. We're raising money. We're going to do some asset management with them. But they've got this incredible platform. It typically creates a stickiness, a community. Look, these are 300 units. This is a community. The interiors look nice, but the outside's embarrassing. The pool's a pond and the playground equipment's breaking down. And so we can actually create this community, not just with the exteriors, which will be a dog park and all that. So that's kind of what I want to focus in on, is bringing those operators to our fund. I talk to a lot of operators. I talk to a lot of LPs. And I always ask the LPs, how many of the people that you've invested with had their S together? I mean, like that reporting, the making them feel like they're part of the deal, not having to hound them on that stuff. The only thing as a fund that we can control is our investors' experience. And that's why we have to go vet the best operators across the country.
What do the really good operators do that the bad operators don't, whether regardless of their experience?
Those operators that are doing monthly reporting as opposed to quarterly reporting or distributions are doing such a better job at servicing their investors, because by the second time that they pay that check, the investor's like, oh, I'm good. No problem. The guys that are doing it quarterly, they got to wait 6 months to kind of earn the trust of their investors. So I think that's it, the communication and making them feel like they're part of it. This is the deal that you invested in. This is kind of where we are. Here's some pictures, here's some videos. It doesn't have to be extensive. You shouldn't be calling your investors, you know, in COVID, or letting them call you and say, hey, look, how come I haven't seen a report in 3 months? This year is when we started to say, hey, look, we're going to bring in more partners and we're going to have to do this right with, you know, SEC, money raising, et cetera. And we want to be investing with the best operators across the country. Let's really build out the fund. You know a little bit about funds. It's a deal for deal fund, a closed end fund. But within that fund, we can have multiple deals with multiple operators.
All right, cool, man. You heard it here first. How the sausage is made, direct from Andy McMullen.
I was kicked out of the homecoming dance and stripped of my crown.